Right, a little while ago I put a new compound slide on my Myford ML7. Well, it's a second hand one, but I found it's got some tight spots over the travel, over the full length of the travel. So today I'm going to take it off, clean it up, and then I'm going to lap it in. So I've just taken the Alaris tool post off, and now I've loosened off the gib screws. So I'm going to take the compound slide right off. And now I'm going to clean it up, blow it all out, clean it up, and clean the gib strip, clean off all the oil, and then I'm going to use some grinding paste to actually lap the gib strip in. And to lap it in, I'm going to take the lead screw part off so I can actually just move it backwards and forwards by hand. And I'm going to use this fine valve grinding paste. And I'm going to lap in both sides, so I'll put some grinding paste on either side there. Put the gib strip on and slide it over the compound assembly there. Then I'm going to lightly tighten the inner screws so it's just touching, and then the outer ones so that they feel all even. Take it off, clean off the valve grinding paste, and do the same procedure again. and see what that does. You can see the gib strip here that is lapped in several places, but there's a dip there, so it's taken off the high spots. I think I'll do it a little bit more and see if I can clear it so it's lapped all the way down. The other side looks dull all the way down, so that's lapped in nicely, so I won't put any grinding paste on that side. This time I'll just put a bit of grease on that side when I'm lapping the gib strip. And this time I'm applying a bit of pressure with my thumbs, pushing it over so that the gib strip is in contact all the way down. And you can see that's getting better all the time. There's a bit of a low spot there, but the rest of it's cleaned up nicely and lapped in. So I'll do it a few more times, and then I shall clean it up and I shall finish off with the lapping with some teacup or whatever. And then I shall see how the compound performs. I can already feel the improvement on that. When you're doing this, basically you're making sure that the grub screws are in the indents on the gib strip, and you can actually just push it to the other side when you're lapping it. Thank you. and that should just take off all those high points. And that there is lapped here all the way down now. So I cleaned up all the grinding paste. And I think I'll leave it at that. I won't use any teacup or anything. I shall just oil it up and grease it up, put it back together again and see how it performs over the full length with the lead screw. And that feels so much better already. so there's no side to side movement now, and it's smooth over the full length of the travel, which is absolutely excellent. And while I've got it in pieces, I'm going to take it off now and I'm going to drill through and tap at the front end here for a locking screw. So it'll lock the Gibbs solid and lock the actual compound when it's not in use. And that saves me having to tighten up on one of the actual grub screws. And to do that, you use my scribe tool here and make it so it's the center of the grub screws there from the face here, and just score that front mark there. I'm only going to put one screw in, so you can see that's the center, and then I can drill that carefully and tap it. It's 2BA in these screws here, so I want to tap it for 2BA the same. So in the end, I've decided to put two locking screws in to make it a little bit more even, and I've marked it up there and there, centre punched that one, and now I'll centre punch this one in the middle, or thereabouts. And now I shall drill through with a 1/8 drill, and then the core diameter for the 2BA screw. It's only soft cast iron, so it's dead easy to drill. And I used the drill to actually put the 2BA down into the workpiece, and then I know that it's absolutely dead square. And you can start off a couple of threads like that and then take it out and finish it in the vise. Oh. or you can start the tap off like that, loosen the chuck off, let the drill up, and then continue the work in the vise like that, and you'll know that that tap is dead square. And that's that job done. So now I've cut the Allen bolts off to length, and now I'm going to just put a pointed end on them on the grinding wheel. And I hold them in the Allen key like that. Right, if you do this modification, you want to aim so that there's only a millimeter between the cap head screw and the side of the compound slide, and that's because the Allen bolt heads there have to clear whatever you've got here, whether it's a nut or an Allen bolt like I've got. And I've also had to turn mine down a bit so it clears the thick washer, but it's only a quarter of a turn and it absolutely locks the compound solid. So unlock, and now those screws will actually clear my Allen bolt here and the washer. And I leave my compound slide locked all the time that I'm not using it. And that feels lovely and smooth already. material is a piece of 316 stainless steel. Mm-hmm.